Welcome to Fill Your Belly with Pat Kelly. Today on the menu, baby back ribs with a nice spice rub. Real simple, we're doing it all inside today.
Tired of deciphering food labels in search of the healthiest choice? At Big Y, they've simplified healthful shopping with the NuVal Nutrition Scoring System. The NuVal system rates foods from 1 to 100, with 100 having the most nutrient bang bite per bite. For more information, contact Big Y's registered dietitians at livingwell@bigy.com or visit bigy.com and click on NuVal.
Welcome to Fill Your Belly with Pat Kelly. Today on the menu, we have an awesome baby back rib recipe for you that all starts with a great rub. Now, there's many ways to do ribs. I like ribs slow and low in the oven. You can do it on the grill if you feel like a hero, but this is definitely the easiest way to do it. The rub consists of all of these spices, which I'll go through right now for you. 1/4 cup of brown sugar, 1/4 cup of paprika, 1 tablespoon of chili powder, and I'm just guessing on this stuff. You know, this is not brain surgery here. About a tablespoon of garlic powder, tablespoon of mustard powder, about a teaspoon of fresh ground pepper. By the way, I love these Big Y grindable pepper things, and also the Big Y grindable salt as well. Love the flake salt, because I'm not a huge salt fan. Don't like the salty stuff too much, but when I do get a nice crack of fresh salt, that's awesome. About a teaspoon of the salt as well. About a teaspoon of oregano, about a teaspoon of basil, and a small dash of cumin, and I mean small. It's a very powerful spice. And your rub is done. Now you just want to mix it up, ready to go. Next thing you want to deal with is the meat. This is a rack of baby back ribs. Awesome. It's already nice and trimmed. I didn't have to do anything to it. Cost me about 10 bucks. The first thing you want to do is you want to take the membrane off of the back of the ribs here, on the rib side of the rib themselves. You know, you got the meaty side, you got the rib side. You want to take that membrane off. Very simple to do. Just take a knife, kind of get underneath it. Just pull it right off. Because you don't want that, you don't want to get that weird sinewy thing on the back of the ribs. You want these things to be nice and moist and meaty. Hey, it's a dirty job, but it's going to pay off for you when you put this thing on the table. People will really appreciate that the ribs are moist all the way through. Okay, that's gonna do it. I'm not gonna split hairs here. Take all that off. You're good to go. This thing is ready for a rub. Look at how nice that looks. Got the rub done. Got the membrane off the back of the ribs. We're ready to apply the rub to the meat. And that's where these things come in handy, among other things. Look, I'm a chicken. Look, I'm a cow. They double as Halloween costumes, okay? These are great because if you don't use them when you're rubbing the spices into the meat, your hands are gonna smell like cumin for the rest of the day. I don't generally use gloves. I don't know why people use it. I've seen cooks use gloves and they just kind of look out of context. It looks like a surgeon in a kitchen. So, gloved. Take this beautiful rub, sprinkle it over the top, and just begin massaging it into the meat. Just rubbing it up and down. You really want to cover every bit of the meat that you can. Just give it a nice rub it into the meat like that. You can also, after you rub it, put it into the refrigerator for an hour just to give it a little bit of a extra marinade. The flavor will kind of soak into the meat a little bit better. You want to get both sides of this too. And it's going to be messy, man. It's going to sprinkle around a little bit. Okay, so you want to make sure that you rub it into every possible little area on both sides of the ribs. Oh, man, that is just... the smell of the spices is already amazing. Flip it back over. We're going to cook it rib side down. And that is a very happy piece of pork ready to go into the oven. Beautiful baby back ribs about to go into the oven. One of the things that's very important is that you keep the oven temperature really low. Not just to make it tender, but sugar burns at 265 degrees. So if you cook it over that, you're gonna get a black top that's gonna taste nasty. I got my oven at 230. We're gonna throw it in for 4 hours, and then we're gonna have the best ribs you've ever had. Fill Your Belly with Pat Kelly. Don't touch it, don't prod it, let the oven do the work. Have a beer, make a drink, football's on. Wow, that was a really great football game. I cannot believe that they blew it again. Oh, look at the time. It is 4 hours later. Let's see if the ribs are done. Oh, if I could climb in there like Hansel and Gretel and hang out with those pork ribs, I would. Look at how amazing that is. 4 hours at 230 degrees, good rub on it. Look at the meat backing off the bones, all juicy and tender. Look at that. That's crazy. Ow, ow. Beautiful rubbed baby back ribs. Fill your belly with Pat Kelly. This isn't gonna hurt a bit. I'm glad you can make it to the office today. You need to learn to relax. All right, that's just gross.